Bishop takes rook. Any idea what that means?
No clue.
You know the summer blockbuster, a massively entertaining popcorn flick. A film where you go to watch without any desire to really dive deeply into. You're just in it for the roller coaster ride of a good time. And as a guy that seldom watches movies nowadays, I'm pretty sure Call of Duty has replaced them for me. I hardly have the attention span to sit through an entire movie anymore besides the rare occasion. Yet, when it comes to video games, it's tremendously easier for me to stomach with that dopamine rush. So, every year, I tend to play the new Call of Duty game solely for its campaign. I haven't touched a Call of Duty multiplayer since the original Modern Warfare in 2007, and that was just because my friends wanted me to try it out. I'm not a big first-person shooter fan, especially when it comes to their multiplayer. Besides spending every night super jumping out of the map in Halo 2 during middle school and getting everyone angry at me during a session of Oddball, I primarily only played them for their campaigns. There's only so much fun I was able to get out of shooting dudes as my guy friend hops on the mic and pretends to be a girl. Mind you, we were hardly even 12 years old by this point and we found it massively hilarious. Until one day, someone sent us a certain kind of picture through Xbox Live chat and, whew, let me tell you, my innocence was robbed that day, and I still remember the guy's name. F you, Jeremy. I hope you go burning. Inappropriate pictures aside, the last multiplayer shooter I played that wasn't cooperative like Destiny 2 was the original Titanfall. I love mechs, so I figured I would like Titanfall even though I didn't enjoy FPS multiplayer games. Every year we'd get the new Call of Duty game, but all my friends bought them just for the online matches so they could brag about being the best player on the blacktop. Being the cheap bum I was, and still am to be fair, it was a great perk for me as I was able to mindlessly play through each and every campaign due to someone I know owning the game. I can't say I was ever hooked, but they were often reliable enough for me to just turn my brain off and know I was in for a good time. None of them hold a candle to the glory that is building an actual relationship to a giant mech like in Titanfall 2. With tons of variety in the movement system that fulfilled my deepest desire to go fast and fly around the air. Fun fact, I once repeatedly jumped off the couch hoping I would glide like Knuckles from the Sonic the Hedgehog games. This explains a lot of my stupidity to be honest, but I was always a complete and utter dumbass even before falling face first trying to emulate a red echidna with hip hop beats in the background. Anyways, when most of my friends stopped playing Call of Duty, and even video games in general, I was left with rarely being able to play a first-person shooter at the time. I was always a frugal person, and I could never really justify spending a full price on a game for a short 5-hour campaign that I would never ever replay again. Not only that, but Call of Duty games were hardly ever on sale on PC. At best, they were only half off even after over a decade. There was no way I would spend $30 to play a 10-year-old campaign that would last me 2-3 nights at most. Except for Advanced Warfare and Infinite Warfare, the advanced tech and space themes really sold me on them, and I've replayed both games several times so far. I can't buy a ticket to go see the next Call of Duty every year, but what I did do was subscribe to Gamefly whenever a new game came out. So it was like my summer game of rentals, but you know, except in the fall usually, using the 2 game rentals at a time subscription. I would play Call of Duty first incredibly quickly, and the second game I had alongside it was usually an RPG because it was long. I could slowly let it simmer as I waited for the next game to come in the mail. Honestly, I could thank Call of Duty for introducing me to 13 Sentinels Aegis Rim as it was one of my favorite games I probably would have never played if I didn't have the option to rent it at the time. I've never really been impressed by any of the Call of Duty campaigns, just the same as I've never really been impressed by the big budget Hollywood film that only titillated my senses, but never broke on through to hit me on a deeper, more emotional level. And you know what? That's perfectly fine. That's what I was looking for. Sometimes you don't want depth, just pleasure. It's purely junk food for me to play the next Call of Duty campaign, and I don't crave it for anything more than just that short-lived hedonic hit. Trust me, I have plenty of other game series that I indulge in for something that'll hit closer to home for me. It's all about balance, you know? I need the mindless to go hand in hand with the mindful. All of this just to say that I'm enjoying my time with Black Ops 4's... Black Ops 6's campaign, where it's pretty spectacle and don't understand when people complain about the game not having an enriching, philosophically poignant story. It's like if I went to the theater to watch the Jump Street movies to learn about the emotional toll it takes on a person to be an undercover cop and having to betray your targets in the name of the law at the cost of camaraderie. They just weren't made for that. And shallow can be fun. Shallow doesn't have to mean bad. Especially when you know you can just dip your toes in for a bit to relax and just as easily move right on when you've had your fill. So, like how my other friend named Jeremy says,
Xbox Game Pass, $9.99 a month on the world's fastest and best gaming console, the Xbox One X. It's a great deal for to access over 500 of your favorite Xbox titles. Also available on the Windows 10 Select support.
You didn't even introduce yourself.
Xbox Game Pass.